to the memory verse of the week. I've got three numbers for you to remember, and I'm going to tell you what they are. 1, 5, and 7. That's right. Wait a minute. Who put those up there? 1, 5, 7. Oh! You're going to remember those. Those don't have to be up there on that board. Whoops, now I got to get back in my chair. Huh. Okay, those numbers are very important because they're going to help us remember the secret code to deciphering God's specific verse that He has for us today. Do you remember what those numbers are? Because they're going to come in handy for other reasons as well. 1, 5, and 7. Okay, now, my name is Ann Graber, which I hope you know now because I just told you. And do I have a verse for you? Well, I was thinking about all the truths we've been learning of the events leading up to Jesus' death and resurrection. And you know, why would we want to learn about that, especially at this time? I was thinking that Jesus brings us new life and He's alive. And when we give our lives to Him, then He brings us new life in Christ. So that's pretty exciting all in itself. So what I was thinking about today in particular are the events that led up to Jesus's death and resurrection. I was thinking about one of Jesus's disciples. Now, you remember the disciples? They were Jesus's best friends. They didn't completely understand what was going on, but they knew they loved Jesus more than they loved their own life and that they were willing to follow Him forever, right? Well, I'm talking about today, this one, and his name is Peter. Did you know Peter was one of the disciples? Good, because he is. Peter's one of the disciples, and when they were all gathered, they gathered at the Last Supper together, they gathered at the Garden of Gethsemane together, and then those were the last few big gatherings that they had, but Jesus said something to Peter that Peter didn't like very much. Because Jesus told Peter that he was going to deny him 3 times. And Peter said, I would never deny you, Lord. I love you. And Jesus says, yeah, you're going to. Well, Peter didn't like that. But lo and behold, when Jesus hung on the cross and then he gave up his life, guess what happened? You're right. Peter denied him 3 times. 3 times he had an opportunity to say that he knew Jesus and he loved Jesus, and 3 times he denied it. Well, I bet if I were Peter, I'd be feeling pretty bad about them. How about you? Man, this is your best friend. So guess what Jesus did when he came back to life? He had a talk with Peter and he said, Peter, he says, that's okay. He says, you just go on and do what you know you need to do. You go on and you spread my love to everybody because that's what I've asked you to do. And Peter says, thank you for the encouragement, Lord. You know, he said, thank you, Lord, I will. And guess what? God had Peter write letters of encouragement to the people that he reached out to. As a matter of fact, he knew that encouragement was so important that he had him write it 2 letters of encouragement. So if you're looking in your Bible, and obviously you would go to the New Testament because Jesus had already been born, you will see that there's a 1 Peter and a 2 Peter. That's how important encouragement is. And especially these days, boys and girls, some days we don't know if we're gonna go to school, if school's gonna be at home, or if school's gonna be at school. So we need those words of encouragement. And this is what Peter is offering to us as well as the people he went. Now, this is where our 1, 5, and 7 come in. Are you ready for this? Because, yes, you're so smart. The 1 stands for the 1 Peter. You're right. So if we look in 1 Peter, we can go to chapter, you got it again, chapter 5. I bet you don't know what verse it is. Yes, you got it. Verse 7. So if we go to 1 Peter, chapter 5, verse 7. Wait, because I brought a Bible. Why did I bring a Bible? Because it's God's words. They're in the Bible. Do you think these words are true? absolutely they're true because they're in the Bible. Everything in the Bible is true. Do you know God said this is the only book you'll ever need because it has all the truths you could ever need? Well, anyway, I'm going to go way in the back here. Oh, look, my little card knew right where it was. That's in case I drop my book. I go to 1 Peter 5:7. La, 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 la. See my big five? Five. Whoops. Five. That's the chapter. And then I can't show you the tiny seven because it's really tiny. And I've got to look at it very closely. Seven. It says, give all your worries to him because he cares for you. Give all your worries to him because he cares for you. 1 Peter 5:7. Give all your worries to him. To Peter? Oh, no, no, no. Give all your worries to God because God cares for you. Now you're thinking, how am I going to remember that verse? What am I going to do that will help me remember? Because it's not super long, but this is what I like to do. Boys and girls, I love to praise and worship God any day, anytime, anywhere. And I usually do that in song. Well, did you know that a lot of songs are actually written from God's words? So we are worshiping God and praising him back, his own words. That makes him happy. Well, I've got a treat for you. If I have some friends, if they're here today, then we should be able to worship God in song with 1 Peter 5:7. But I'm gonna need your help to call them, okay? It's gonna have to be a big, loud call. And they know the numbers 1, 5, 7. So if you would with me, shout them as loudly as you can, we may actually find them. Are you ready? Ready? Here we go. 1, 5, 7! Oh my goodness, that GFBC education program, Miss Ann Baker's class was so good. Oh, I'm so glad they were able to help us. Woo-wee. But boys and girls, just thinking about that, I found a book in my piano bench. And I was looking through all the songs of praise and worship that I like to sing to God. And do you know what? Most of them are actually God's words that I'm singing back to Him. They're scripture. So look at all the songs that you're singing and see if you're singing scripture too, because God really likes that. And you know, using signs when you sing helps us remember what the words are. And I brought me a big sign today for you. Do you know what this sign means? It's universal. You put your finger up. This pinky has trouble. You put your finger up, it means I love you. I love you. That is why I gave you 1 Peter 5:7 today, so you would be encouraged. And you take this sign, I love you, and 1 Peter 5:7, and spread encouragement and love all over your neighborhood. Sounds like a plan.